What's going on YouTube? I'm gonna just go ahead and dive into the video. Here, my client, he's gonna get a mid-ball taper fade. And, you know, I'm gonna start the process now. Here, I have my 1.5 guard on my wall magic clip. And I'm just trying to trim the hair down to the desired length. This particular client, his hair grows in different directions, you know, in certain parts of his head. So, you know, if you have a client who has he has a good grade of hair, but if his hair grows in different directions, you know, especially once you get used to it, you can kind of know the pattern. So it's always good to make sure you comb it out and use a bigger guard so therefore you don't necessarily take it lower than what you want. So this is basically what I'm doing with the 1.5 for my magic clip. Just trimming it down, and you can see how his the pattern, the direction of his hair, you can kind of see it. And this is before I even start to get it to the desired length, you know, as far as cutting it down. So, and I'm just gonna show you this magic and how it works. So I'm just trimming it down right now, going with the direction that his hair goes, and that's the way that I'm trimming it down. So check it out. Here, I'm taking my wall magic clip and I'm doing the back part of the taper. I don't necessarily have to use my edges with this. I'm just balding it out so I can start the fade process, and I put my one guard on, just kind of go up about an inch to kind of start the fading process of it on both sides. And this is here, and right above where my clippers are is where he wears a wave cap. So that area right there, this is where the challenge, I'm gonna have to do a blend. I'm gonna have to really get up in there so it doesn't stay too dark in that particular area. And I'll show you as I go. So, you know, I'm just using my magic clip with my one guard, just trying to go around his ears. I'm gonna start the taper part on the right side and the left side. And I just use my one guard to kind of start and I open it up, you know, that way I don't take it too close. Remember, you know, the less you cut, you can always cut more off, but you can't put the hair back on. So just kind of take my time here and just slowly but surely just kind of flick out the line that I originally created. And I'll use the different guards to kind of get that line going. You'll see as I start the process with this. Here, because his hair grows in different directions on this side of his head, that's why you see me cutting at, you know, sometimes I'll go down, I gotta kind of go against the grain, but I'm making sure I'm using my 1.5 guard because I don't want to cut too much off. Like right here, you see me going with the grain, then I go against the grain. I'm just trying to get it where it's at a level where he can brush it and it doesn't look like a plug or anything like that. I have this is my one guard, kind of going against the grain. You can see what I'm doing here. And right up around his ear, you can tell where it grows in different patterns. Right here, I'm going to take my 1.5 guard, and right there is the area where he wears his wave cap. And it's a dark area. So I put my 1.5 guard on and I open it up and I just kind of flick out that line. and I'm gonna do it in layers, all right? And as I stated to you before, you know, I might have to cut in different direction because of that. So I take my my one guard, and I kind of flick out that line too. I just flick it out, and I'm trying to blend it in. So as I'm trying to blend it in, I'm just taking steps, and I'm going in between my one guard and my half guard, and I'm just kind of flicking out that line, and just barely tapping it, but I don't want to create another line. But I had to use my one and a half guard, and I had to open it up to kind of get that dark area to start to debulk that area, just like I'm doing now. I'm debulking that with the one and a half, and I just try to kind of flick it out, and when it can't do anymore, I go to my one guard, and I open it up, and I start flicking it out, just like this. Because if I don't, that area would have been too dark, and you could tell that it hadn't been properly faded. And you'll see what I do. And because, as I stated earlier in the video, his hair grows in different directions, you'll see me, you know, like in the beginning of the video, on the left side of his head, you'll see me kind of cut in different directions. And that's because I know the pattern, the way that his hair grows, and that's the purpose of doing that. So I'm starting the taper part on the right side. And again, here's my one and a half. All right. This on the right side, his hair, it seems to grow all in the same direction, but it's the left side where, you know, it kind of grows in different directions, and I have to make sure I follow the way that it's growing. So that's the reason why, you know, I kind of do it that way. But I'm repeating the same process on this side. Make sure that I don't take too much off. I always start with the bigger guard, and I just kind of work my way down depending on, you know, the desired length and how faded it is. Get the tape on both sides and in the back. And here I'm spraying my Peking Nose hairspray. It's kind of like a holding spray, like a spritz sort of. And just I spray it, I kind of let it dry, and you'll see me just kind of, again, I'm using my one and a half, and I'm just kind of trimming the hair down. You can see here, especially this side, you know, has a great course of hair and the way that it grows. And on the other side, it just kind of grows a little different. So I'm very particular in making sure that I don't cut too much off, or I don't have the right guard on or set at the right level. So that's basically what that is. So as I trim his mustache, I'm letting the holding spray that I sprayed kind of set in, kind of freezes the hair, and it will make it a lot easier to edge him up. And you'll see that in the process of doing that. So check it out. Now, once doing his little goatee, I'm gonna take my gold FX trimmers, and I'm gonna start lining him up in the back. All right, this is, of course, most barbers, lining a client up is the favorite part of the haircut, and it's the best looking part of the haircut. So, right around his ears, you just being very gentle, because most people are very sensitive around their neck and around their ears. So just making sure that I'm not too heavy-handed, because I know I probably can be. And that's something for beginner barbers. You know, you have to gauge that, you know, with certain clients, or just as the more experience you get. You can see, well, I'm using these Gold FX trimmers, and they hit. Even considering that the back part of his head is faded, and you can still see where they edge up pretty good. And instead of me kind of doing the bald part of the taper at the beginning, I kind of like do it towards the end. That way I don't create another line in the process at the beginning, and I can, once it's faded, it's easier to just kind of take your edges and make it bald. So I'm starting with the edge here, and you can see when I turn my camera how they hit. Look at these edges. Look at it. Damn. This is one of my old school clients. He's very traditional. He does not use any enhancements. So this is just regular, just edges and trimmers. I mean, clippers. No enhancements here. And you can see how that holding spray, it helps. So if you never use that strategy, try to use that strategy, and you'll adjust to it, and you might think that it'll be beneficial to you as well. And that's basically what I'm doing. I love these trimmers. If you don't have them, you know, you need to get you a pair. And as I go around, I'm just barely tapping. I'm just tapping it. And now I'm doing his vertical bar on this side. And around these, and you'll see I kind of bowed this little taper part here. Over with the 1.5, just kind of doing some little fine tuning to make sure you get the look that you want. You see on that side his hair goes all in one direction, but on the other side it kind of grows in like a couple of different directions. You have to be careful, make sure that you don't cut too much, because it grows in a different way. So, and some of you, if you have a collie in front of your head, you know exactly what I'm talking about. The barber could just be trimming off your hair, and because it's in the front of your head, it may cut off a little bit much more than what you expected. So you gotta, with that colleague, most people have their colleague, or you may call it a swirl, in the back of their head. And if that's the case, then you know, with the colleague, you want to put a bigger guard on, that way you don't cut as much, because it can look like a plug. It can look like he's thinning or whatnot. And he's definitely, in this particular kind, he's not thinning at all. I'm just using the regular razor on him, just to get a precise look and edge. Just making sure that it's pieced together. Here we go. Here I am in the spring of 2019 at the first annual Houston Barber Battle, and I competed and got first and second place in two different competitions.